How do you see this election and what issues are you fighting?
I'm fighting these elections on the development. I'm fighting these elections for the development of Bangalore city. I'm fighting these elections because the MP who has got elected has not been active, has not done anything significant to for the development of Bangalore city. That is the main election, and I have after losing, I have been around people, I have done a lot of work for the constituency, I have served the people irrespective of caste and community, and I assure them that tomorrow, if they bless me, I'll be there to serve them. I'll make this city, which is an international city, and I'll be a very vocal voice for the development of Bangalore city.
How you take Prakash Raj how serious, because he is going to cut a lot of secular vote, and there is a problem.
See, there is no vote which is secular and no vote which is communal. You know, the vote is for development. I don't believe in secular and communal politics. I believe in the politics of development.
Whoever talks, they will love BJP.
No, it's not necessary. Today, a lot of people who had voted BJP earlier are voting for me because they know that BJP has failed in developing the city. They want a change. They want to now vote a youngster. So there is no vote which you can brand as one political party's vote and not going to have another politics. In public life, it doesn't work like that. People will judge us on our work. People will judge us on what issues we are raising and what vision we have for the constituency. So, I really feel today that people are very clear that they want a change. They want more active MP who can take up and raise their voice for them.
What is the first thing you do when you become MP for Bangalore?
It's not about the first thing. It's about every day doing something. Being rising your voice, coming to the rescue, trying to intervene in everything which is going wrong, and you know, and truly to raise the bar in politics and bring in more development. And it's a continuous process. It's a continuous process.
Sir, in the central leadership, how confident are you that Rahul Gandhi would lead this thing and become the Prime Minister? How confident are you?
I am very confident because people across India want a change. They are fed up with Mr. Modi's false promises. They are fed up with the kind of politics BJP has pursued in last 5 years. And lot of injustice done to the common man. So people want a change now. They are fed up with the false promises, you know. So they want to change, and Mr. Rahul Gandhi has been consistently highlighting the failure of this government, and he has gone to the people. He is a trusted, tested and trusted leader. Under his leadership, we won 3 states of the Hindi heartland, and I am very, very confident that under his leadership, when all the parties which are democratic, which believes in pluralistic politics, they all have come together, and I'm confident that under Mr. Rahul Gandhi's leadership.
Two days back, Rahul Gandhi brought an initiative saying that they'll give 72,000 per family, garibi hatao, and Modi and the opposition.
No, it's not.
It's a bluff, and it's not. How do you see this?
It's not that he's giving 72,000 per family for free of cost. When Narega was brought in, rural people were assured 100 days of employment, and they were paid money when after getting work done from them. When we announced that scheme, even then BJP said it is a bluff, it doesn't work like that. So, but we have shown that it works, and it is in the interest of the society, and it is in the interest of the country that people get assured days of income. And same thing is getting it done in the urban areas. So the urban areas also, a scheme like Narega will come, where there will be a minimum guarantee of income for every individual in cities. So we welcome them. BJP cannot tolerate this because they cannot even think and conceive a scheme like this.
This will not become like a Jumla of 15 lakhs.
I've told you that Narega, we made it work. This will happen.
And yesterday, Mr. Modi is taking credit for that space thing. This initiative was done by your former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. So what is your say on that?
See, governments come and go. But the asset of this government, of this country, is our scientists who developed this. Is the political leadership which had the will, political will, to make this happen. And I don't want to say that credit should go to Congress, credit should go to somebody else. I want to say that our scientists in DRDO, our scientists in ISRO, our scientists in different institutions are doing wonderful work. And political leaders should not take credit for their cheap politics, for votes. They should not take credit. It is the hard work of our scientists, and they should get the credit.
Sir, how many seats are you expecting in center in Karnataka?
More than 20 seats.
And in center, sir?
I mean, center means?
Sir, you're forming the government, you need.
No, we will form the government. No, we will form the government. Our alliance UPA will form the government.
Thank you.
Thank you.